Welcome to Tips on How to Prevent Carpal Tunnel Syndrome in the Workplace. I'm Dr. Carla Cupido. Carpal tunnel syndrome is the most common compression neuropathy in the upper extremity. It's also one that is so prevalent that it causes 1 million people annually to seek medical care, or they are considered temporarily disabled by this condition. It's also so common that over 200,000 people in the U.S. are annually receiving decompression surgeries for this condition. So why is this condition so prevalent? Why is carpal tunnel syndrome becoming such a regular condition seen in our society? Well, there's a number of reasons, a lot of speculation, and a lot of evidence in the research. However, there's a lot of things that haven't been decided on completely. Some of the predisposing factors that are discussed are diabetes, obesity, smoking, working on a keyboard, using a mouse, working at a factory. There's all sorts of things now that are being linked to this condition called carpal tunnel syndrome. So, since there are so many reasons that are being disputed in the research, I'm going to talk about some of the more mechanical factors that can come into place in a regular day at the office. So let's first discuss the anatomy of the carpal tunnel. The carpal tunnel exists in the wrist. It's formed by the carpal bones on the bottom side and the transverse carpal ligament on the top. Through this tunnel travel the tendons that supply the hand and the wrist for the ability to flex. The other main component of the carpal tunnel is the median nerve. It's when this median nerve is compressed that we end up with the condition carpal tunnel syndrome. When the median nerve is compressed, you end up with symptoms such as pain, burning, numbness, tingling, and even weakness into the hand. Most specifically, it runs into the thumb, the second, third, and half of the fourth finger on the palmar side of the hand, as well as the majority of the back side of the hand or dorsal side of the hand. Carpal tunnel syndrome can be caused by a number of reasons. First is due to position. So if the wrist is extended considerably, or if it is flexed considerably, the space available in the carpal tunnel is compromised. Therefore, the median nerve is more likely to be compressed. Another reason that this can happen is through an actual load on the carpal tunnel. So when people do yoga, a lot of the time they push through the carpal tunnel, causing an actual compression to the median nerve. Another reason is due to an inflammation through the carpal tunnel. So if you're using finger flexion and wrist flexion on a regular basis, the tendons become often inflamed. So the lining that surrounds the tendons, known as the synovium, swells. And so then you end up with, again, a decreased space in the carpal tunnel. The problems that seem to be the most common in the workplace are repetitive activities. So there's dispute on whether using the keyboard and contracting the fingers and flexion on a regular basis is a cause of carpal tunnel. It seems less likely that that's the cause, and more likely that something like working in a factory with forceful contractions of the wrist and finger flexors would be the cause. It's also been shown that using a mouse, where people overgrip on a mouse all day, can be another predisposing factor to carpal tunnel syndrome. The median nerve originates from the spinal cord through the nerve roots, as well as through the brachial plexus, which runs behind one of the three scalenes. There are three scalene muscles that start from the neck and move down into the ribs. The first scalene is known as the anterior scalene, and behind this is where the brachial plexus travels. So the brachial plexus is a really thick bundle of nerves that actually supplies the entire arm and hand. So if the anterior scalene is really tight, what happens is that it places a compression on the brachial plexus. The brachial plexus then is being altered in its nerve function, and the chances of a neuropathy existing lower down in the arm is much more common. So this is called a double crush condition. So when the nerve is compressed or crushed higher up, the chances of it being crushed or compressed lower down are more likely. So this can happen at a number of sites. It can happen at the anterior scalene, like we just talked about. It can happen through the pectoralis minor, which is in this area of the body, and it can also happen through a number of sites in the forearm. The carpal tunnel is the last compressive site for the median nerve, which is essentially carpal tunnel syndrome.